to.
So now, wait a minute. You had 24 hours to do this. That generator thing must have taken you forever.
Incorrect, my friend.
Okay.
Actually, it took approximately, to do all of the effects with the Q-spots and to do all of the effects with the reins and the 200Bs, it probably took me no more than about 15 minutes.
That's amazing. That is just massively amazing.
Yes.
You also had a haze machine sitting out there. You used the Arena Hazer?
I did.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely.
Arena Hazer.
That thing is a workhorse, and I love it.
Yeah.
And if there's any band that needs a haze machine, this is the one to get. Not only does it come in a road case, I mean, it's ready to travel, but it doesn't turn off. It never stops.
Yeah, that's you know? One of the things that I hear, that you can put a 55-gallon drum there and just stick a tube in it, it's going to suck it dry.
It will.
Okay.
And the adjustable output was fantastic. The blower, the fan was fantastic. I can angle it. I can turn it wherever I wanted it or didn't want it. You know, it offered me a lot of flexibility with the output, with the controls I had via DMX. I mean, it was unbelievable. And personally, I would buy it.
Okay, very cool. Are there any fixtures we forgot? Because you had a lot of fixtures.
There were a lot up there. I believe the LED technostrobes.
Oh, okay.
The actual white LED version.
Okay, the SC3000 LED.
Right.
Okay.
And
what did you use that for? Why'd you choose that with all these colors you got? What's going on with that?
Well, I wanted an actual white source of light for the drummer, because the drummer did a few solos, a little bit more than the other band members. And when they were doing video, I wanted it to look normal. I wanted the color temperature of the skin to be a little bit closer to his actual tone. So I chose four of those, which helped raise the color temperature of the overall room. And because I'm able to dim those with the DMX with Show Express, I'm able to do funky patterns with it. It gave me the effect that I was looking for. So I can dim it in or I can bring it back out. And then when the band was going crazy, I was able to strobe them all at the same time, you know.
Yeah, and that's really cool. I mean, it is LED, and everybody loves it. That's energy efficient.
Absolutely.
You know, but what's the, you know, with that techno strobe, you had four of those.
Right.
You know, compared to using a regular strobe light, you know?
Well, it's difficult, you know, and I get that question all the time. Someone is looking for an 800-watt or 750-watt strobe light. It's not going to be, you can't take one and put one together. It's going to take a few more of the LED techno strobes to equal that because of the overall output. But when you've got four of them and you've got them delayed at different strobe rates, you know, you can't beat that.
Yeah, I mean, because now you're getting more speed.
Uh-huh.
You can still do dimming.
Absolutely.
And then you've got still the programs built in it to have more fun, too.
And I can trigger all of those right from Show Express.
So did we forget anything in this rig that you put together?
I don't think so.
I think you pretty much covered it.
Yeah, that's
but now, once again, we go back to, you did it in 24 hours.
Right.
But you did it on 120 amp circuit.
Yes.
You're kidding me.
No, not kidding you at all.
Oh, my God.
You know, it's funny, the specifications that are listed in our catalog and on our website, you know, they list it for the fixture at full white. So I actually calculated, but before, you know, obviously this went up, what it would take, and I'm like, that can't be right, because it came out to like 25 amps.
Mm-hmm.
And that didn't include the band's equipment. So I'm thinking, what is going on here? And then I remembered, when we calculate the current draw of the fixtures, that's everything at full white.
Gotcha. Okay.
So when I'm only using red or just blue, for example,
it gives you a little bit
a
more.
It's a third of what it really
gives
is.
A lot more.
Exactly.
Okay.
I actually had about two and a half amps of room left afterwards. So.
So how did the guys feel about this? Were they really impressed? Because I know you brought two bands in.
Right.
How did they feel about being on this new site and everything?
Right. Well, being that we are in a South Florida warehouse, the temperature in here is normally relatively warm.
Not here in Florida. Are you kidding me?
No. Yeah.
But how did that affect those guys? I mean, were they up there sweating? I mean, you know, in the video and everything? I know when the lights are blinking, you don't see sweat beads. Were those guys really toughing it out and sweating?
Well, because of the Florida heat, I got to say, yes, they were sweating. However, when they walked in and saw the rig for the first time, they looked up, they saw all those park hands up there, they saw all the fixtures, they didn't know what it was. They was like, oh my gosh, they were ready to walk out because they thought they were conventional park hands.
Gotcha.
So when I turned everything on for them, I told them to stick their hand up and touch the fixture, put their hand in front of the output, they were blown away. There was no heat whatsoever. So they're like, oh, that's rock. They were ready to go. So that definitely helped, having all of the LEDs versus, you know, the park hands. And they walked in, they loved it, they set up their stuff, and they just rocked out.
Well, I tell you what, I saw the rig, and I think you and your staff did a wonderful. How many guys did you have, actually, that had to do all this in 24 hours again? Well, I keep on thinking of these numbers, 24 hours, 20 amp circuit. How many people did you have? You must have had 10, 15 people to do this.
Not even close, actually. Including myself, there were three guys.
Oh, okay.
There was me and two other guys, and That included setting up the trussing, which pretty much was half the day, setting up the trussing, bolting the trussing together, rigging the motors, you know, getting the right spot, and then flying the truss. Once the truss was flown, we flew. Because a lot of the products here have the linkable power. They have the daisy chaining of the DMX also.
Oh, that's right. We didn't talk about the linkable power.
Exactly.
That's
so
a glorious
we didn't have
thing.
To run extension cords.
Wow. that I love right off the bat.
And that saved
not having to carry extension cords
exactly.
to the gig. You're great.
No Rubbermaid. You know, you just link the fixture to the next fixture, and it was done.
Well, I got to tell you, I saw the rig. I thought it was super fantastic.
Thank
the guys had fun. You
oh,
did
yeah.
a great job.
Thank you very much. Always appreciated.